love bugs. It's Roslynn back at you one more again. I hope everybody is doing blessed. I'm doing blessed and highly favored, and definitely hope the same for you. And if this is your first time coming to my channel, much love to you and welcome. And to my returning subs, my growing extended beautiful family, just thank you for the support, for you basically validating that, you know, my videos really do help. They are resonating with you to let you know, basically the validations let you know, we're going to go through things, but we will be okay. And with that being said, much love to all. Namaste, love and blessings, love and light. And many blessings are definitely coming your way. And if you have been watching my videos for a while and have not already, what are you waiting for? Like and subscribe, even hit that notification bell so you know when I'm about to upload my next video. If you're comfortable enough, please go ahead and drop me a line or two. I would love a chance to get to know you as much as you're getting to know me, even if it's about the positive feedback of the content of my video, or you're just up telling me about your empathic gift and how it impacts your life and sends you towards a positive direction. And if you feel like the video has been very informative to you and it just gave you some good vibes you would love to share with a loved one or friend, please go ahead and do so. And while you're at it, go ahead and give me a thumbs up, like, and even share on your social media favorites as well. And thank you once again for stopping by my channel. I hope you're able, thank you for stopping by my channel, showing love and support to my videos and channel. And I hope you're able to resonate with the content of my video. That's what I meant to say. This peaceful meditation, I love when I hear something can really calm me down. It's called Deep Healing Music for the Body and Soul. Clearing subconscious negativity, relax the mind and body. And I'll post that link in the description box below. And my video today is about Twin Flame 101. Heyoka is finding peace through the turmoil. You have to find a peace through the turmoil, because it's just like sometimes, especially as empaths, we can go through a lot of stuff. We can endure. Things gravitate towards us that can be unbearable at times. And it's just like we're already going through personal life. It feels like you're going through your own personal nightmare, especially if you're an indigo. You know, you have gone through so many things, and it's like you're living in your own personal hell over and over and over again until the lesson is learned. And it's like when I look at life, you know, and I tell y'all this a lot, you know, and some people are new to coming to the channel, it's like you have to really, you know, sometimes we sell ourselves short. We don't give ourselves credit for a lot of things that we endure because we're so busy looking at it in a negative light, in a negative perspective. And I catch myself doing that a lot, especially when things hit you like a ton of bricks, when you can have things going through all different directions where you just feel like, you know, when is it going to end? When can I wake up from this nightmare? It's just, you know, you just feel like the things that you're going through, this has to be a nightmare. I'm just in a coma or something like this, and I'm going to wake up just like in the soap operas or just like in the movies and say, this has been a nightmare. My life is really not like that. But, you know, it's like we played this part in our lives before, but it's just like we have gone through this stage, each and every life source that we have went through. We have went through something very similar that we just didn't learn from it, and then we had to pass on just to have to go through it all again. And then that's when we have to really look at it, like, look at all the things you've been through. We feel at that time when we go through things, we're not going to get through it. We're not going to have the strength to make it. You know, why is this happening to me? Why am I being punished? And you have to really look at it like, you know what? Look at all the things I have overcome. Look at the things that I felt like I was not going to be able to get through when it took me that time to have to go through it. And all it does is take time, and how you can really look at things and see that you're blessed, because it could have been far worse than what it initially was, you know. And it's just like you, when you go through things, you know, and it can be really messed up at the time on what you're going through, because like I tell you, I don't know your situation. God knows your situation. Universe knows your situation. You know your situation. But I know what you went through was like, you feel like you did not deserve this. Certain things that we have went through that we felt like we done got away with, we're paying for it now in some kind of way. You might have felt like, oh, I did this and, you know, karma didn't catch up with me yet. But you're paying for stuff now. Trust me, you're paying for stuff now, because you will go back in life like, dang, whose coffee did I pee in this morning? Who did, you know, whose mama did I kick? You know, this and this and that. You will look down the lifeline of the things that you have done when you have came across people. And there are sometimes we have done things to people that, you know, didn't deserve things either. But that was the card that they were dealt at the time. And it's just like, you know, you can't play victim to yourself. Woe is me. This happened, because, you know, I used to play that. You know, oh, I went through this and this and this and that. But I can say, you know what? I was that victim, but I will not continue to be that victim. I will not continue to be the product of my situation. I have to look at, you know what? I'm doing so many positive things because of the situations I've been put in, the things that, you know, I was forced to have to deal with because my life was controlled. My life was fraudulent and, you know, altered, you know, to somebody else's life and to somebody else's comfort. But when you can be able to arise from all that and don't even wish nothing bad on those people, because it's just like anybody that has hurt me in the past, I've been like, you know, I was angry. I wanted to get back at them. I wanted justice to be served. I want to see them hurt like me. I don't even want that. I don't even want that. Even the situation I'm in, you know, if when y'all truly know the whole story of everything I've been through, you will look like, wow. And she didn't wish nothing on nobody. She didn't want to hurt nobody. You know, people that go through situations like this, and you endure so much pain that sometimes you want to inflict that same pain on people, but it does not make you any better than the person that inflicted on you. You are no better than them. And I had to keep looking at myself like that. You can't inflict pain. You know, who is learning? Nobody's learning anything. So that's why I had to really look at it like, you know what? My problems, my hurt, my pain, you know, me not knowing my family, me being stripped away from my father, not able to know him, you know, look how much good he has done on his side of being able to help people heal in ways he never knew. Look at the things that I'm doing my way, not living in his shadow, but doing things my way on helping people get there to understand, you know, put understanding to the pain and the sorrow and the mishaps and the delays that you have to go through, you know. And it can be really crazy and it can be really hurtful, but when we look at things in a different perspective and know, okay, yeah, I've been through this, but, you know, look how much growth I've absorbed from the pain that I went through, the things that I got delayed from, that I felt like it was meant for me at that time. Look how much I've learned, so much more about myself. And that's what universe wants us to see. When we're heading towards a blessing and we get upset when things are pushed back and delayed for us, that gives you a time. And I've said that many times in videos. That gives you time to work on you. That gives your time, you give yourself that time to educate yourself on more about your gift, the things that you can do to help heal yourself, to make yourself look at things a lot better, to be able to push your story out, to be able to push something out from something to be so tragic to end out to be something so positive that you can be able to, you know, set an example for yourself as well as others. So I hope you are able to, you know, resonate with the content of this video, knowing there's always a meaning for things that you go through. There's always a purpose for the things that you go through. So don't be hard on the other people, even though that's hard to say when you go through something. But when, if you've been with me for a while and know the things that I went through, and I can say that about the people that are close to me that I can help hold accountable, I can't hold them accountable for anything anymore, because it's like there is nothing else can be done about that situation except make it better. So send out as much love and light and positivity as you possibly can, knowing that you are blessed and highly favored and truly loved, knowing there is always somebody out there praying for your better days. And, you know, I'm sending out infinite abundance, much love and light, uplifting vibes, encouraging vibes, and loving vibes, especially if you truly need them. And give me a thumbs up, like, and even share on your social media favorites. You know, drop me a line or two. I love a chance to get to know you as much as you're getting to know me. And, you know, go ahead and give me a thumbs up, like, and even share on your social media favorites. And make sure you hit that notification bell so you know when I'm about to upload my next video. And I'm going to give my post notification shout out to, let me see, I got a whole bunch of people's names written down. Jabriant Mistral. What's up, fam? Jabriant Mitchell. I'm getting tongue-tied because I've been drinking water, y'all, and I need some more water because I'm feeling dehydrated today. So, Jabriant, I hope you're having a good day, fam, and a blessed week. And I will talk to y'all later. Much love, peace, and be wild.